standardization framework is a simple way to bring relevant standards from non-traditional standard setting organizations to an equal footing with European standards when it comes to achieving interoperability. And I'm thinking here of bodies like the World Wide Web Consortium, OASIS, or similar fora and consortia. This could be done via fast track, and fast track approval of their standards through a process hosted by a traditional European standards body. And that could be ETSI, or through the assessment of those bodies' compliance with certain criteria regarding not only openness, consensus, balance, and transparency. And second, we must use all the opportunities to promote appropriate rules, for example, disclosures of essential IPR and licensing conditions in standard setting context. And believe me, I have nothing against IP being brought to the standard setting table, but it must be disclosed. Any economist will tell you that you can only make a rational decision between different options if you can compare, and if you can compare the benefits and the costs, so to say. And let's face it, establishing FRAND, the fair, the reasonable, and the non-discriminatory prices, is a hard task over which reasonable people often disagree. And I can assure you, we have big discussions on that issue in my last term in office. And transparency is therefore in everyone's interest. And the alternatives are not. So why risk the litigation? Why set a standard in ignorance of the cost or implementation? In some cases, the choice of a technology in a standard might be obvious in absence of technical alternatives. Cost and licensing conditions are less relevant in such cases. But in most cases, let's be honest, there are competing options, and it makes clear sense to also consider that information. The Commission has already taken an important step by drafting new guidelines on the application of the treaty's antitrust rules to horizontal agreements, and you remember that, to promote an efficient and a competitive standard setting process that is protected against misuse. And the draft, which is currently available for public comment, relies on the well-established concepts of non-discrimination, transparency, and availability, and specifies minimum requirements that is